So Renee's going to show us kind of how to, because the deck is huge. The deck is, I don't know, 200 cards in it. And so show us how to use it and what different games we can play. And we're not going to go through everything, but if we teach you one, then when you read the directions, you're like, oh, I need this and can use that, but kind of need some explanation to get us started. So Renee, kick us off with your first chart.
So I love that you said that, because we would never anticipate or expect teachers or parents to play or children to play with the entire deck at the same time. So on the first page of directions for both decks, I've given you some just brief ideas. And so the easiest way for me to explain this was to put it into a chart, because there are 16 different representations of the quantities, either 0 to 10 or 1 to 10, based depending on which thing. And I'll talk about that in just a second. But the second deck has an additional 16 representations of the numbers 11 through 20, because we know that the teen numbers are difficult for our young children to learn. And so this just gives them some additional practice with those teen numbers. So the first deck I'm going to talk about are the lower quantities, the ones that run from 0 to 10, or in some cases 1 to 10. So the chart you see in front of you right now tells us what those 16 representations are. Tens, frames, tally marks, number line, and the word form run across that top row. And so all the way down, you see 16 different ways that those quantities can be represented. And we want kids to learn over the course of time that all of those different representations still mean the same thing, that they're still representing that same amount. So the way this chart works is you have four suits, and to make it easy for kids and so that they were also kind of still focusing on shapes, we used, instead of regular card suits, we used the star, the heart, the triangle, and the square as our suits. So on each color, you will have a star or a heart or a triangle or a square. So the colors running across are the colors of the frame that surrounds each representation. And the color was used to indicate the level of complexity for our youngest children. So most of our young children who have been in school at all or preschool will recognize a quantity in a tens frame. It's not as familiar to us as adults, because that's not how we learned. It wasn't a tool that we grew up with, but we're going to explain it a little better in a minute. But the tens frames are easier for a child to recognize than maybe the tally marks, because kids have to learn how tally marks work, that on the fifth one we cross across the four before, and so they're not as recognizable to our youngest children. Same way with the number line, and certainly the word form, until they learn to read the words, that's the most complicated of the representations for the stars. So when you think about it, to make two to four players have an equal chance of recognizing their quantity, we needed to make an easy version for every suit. So when I am looking down this green column, we figure that kids have the best chance of recognizing the number four when it's built on a tens frame with dominoes, with fingers on the hand. So those are the representations we put in the green column, because we think those are the easiest for kids to recognize. As we move from left to right on that chart, the representation gets a little more difficult for kids to recognize easily. So the first thing we would do is we would play games with our youngest children only having representations in that green column. So Tammy might have the star, so she'd have the mixed tens frames. I might have the hearts, so I would have the dominoes. Somebody else might have the fingers on the hand, so they would have triangles. But we would all have kind of about the same chance of being able to recognize all three of those. Does that make sense, Tammy? Or do you have questions?
It does.
Okay.
So what's the orange highlighting for?
Yeah, so the orange highlighting represents the cards that we were able to use as a zero. So if you think about the ones that are in white, we don't have a way to represent a tally mark zero unless we just leave the card blank. And the same would be true of playing cards. We don't have a zero on a regular deck of playing cards. So the ones that are in white only run from 1 to 10. The ones in orange have a 0 to 10. Okay?
All right. Go ahead and tell us about the next deck.
Okay, so the next deck has the same a very similar chart on it, and it works the same way with the suits and the green column being the easiest to recognize. However, this time the highlighting doesn't mean that there's a zero. It means that like the double tens frame mixed would go right along with the tens frame from the original deck. So we could actually play a game from zero all the way to 20 with both decks if we used the tens frame mixed or the double tens frame mixed. So the chart works exactly the same. It tells you what the 16 representations are. A few of them, we had to change what the representation was because we didn't have what was in the original deck. So we had to make a different representation for 11 through 20.